moi, c'était un grand plaisir d'avoir la possibilité de vous rencontrer.
C'est vrai,
Monsieur Jacques Desbrière. I will talk in English.
Yes.
It's very strange sometimes when you just hear something and you feel so very touched by a music. The thing for me was that I, some years ago, started to work with this spectacle, this stage show about Camille Claudel. I'm a singer, I'm a composer, but in the later years I have seen myself more as a storyteller. And I am very interested in the French artists around La Belle Époque. So I had an idea that I would like, I'd made a lot of research, I wanted to tell the story, but I also wanted to mix it with some nice French music. I've already known Cecilia for some time, and I know her qualities as a pianist. And then I heard this CD with your music, Huit, préludes, intérieur. I just felt, this is Camille. It was like her different stages in life, from the very brilliant and burning person in the beginning, the love, the romantic story with Rodin, of course, and then the very vide, the loneliness in the end at Monteverg. You could really hear that in the music. And I also knew that Cecilia had a very strong feeling for Camille Claudel. For me, it was like, I am the storyteller in the stage show, I'm the different voices of Camille's life, and it's like Cecilia sculptured the music and is really the soul of Camille Claudel.
The sculpture and music are a bit the same, in
it
a way.
Is. It is.
Because you have to work on material.
Yes.
Well, sculpture is hard material usually. Marmory or stone. Music is something quite... But it's the same in the end. The same. He feels it. And he has to take it out. Take and get out what is not necessary on it without spoiling it. This is very difficult.
Yes.
And then
yes.
It's the same work for the musician. The pieces, the writing is already there somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
The only problem is to get it out.
Yes.
See?
Yes.
Well,
exactly.